Welcome to this video. Today we are going to see some frequently used shortcut keys in Excel. The combination of control plus arrow or control shift arrow or shift arrow, these are frequently we'll be using. Of course, there are a number of shortcut keys are there in Excel. Just to go into the Google browser, you can find the shortcut keys of Excel. Now we are going to see control and shift plus arrow keys. Okay, let us assume this is my data available here. So I want to browse from one place to another place, or one column to another column, whatever may be. So here, for example, easy understanding purpose, I'm giving some titles, variable one, and the same thing till the last column. I'm just holding it and dragging till end so that automatically the Excel generates variables for me, right? Now this is the titles. Okay, now see control and right click, the control cursor comes to this place, isn't it? Then control left arrow, again we are coming here, right? So this is the way we can move from left to right or right to left extreme ends. In case, if you want to come down, control downward arrow, control upward arrow. See, simply we are able to travel from one place to another place very quick manner. So this is the use of the control plus arrow. In case, if you are using shift plus arrow, you see, I am holding the shift key and arrow key. Now I am moving one cell to one cell, or downward also, downward arrow, holding the shift key, downward arrow, we are moving cell by cell downwards, right? So now I want to right side selected, all the rows are simply coming to right side. So this is the way we can make use. In case control and shift combination, hold the control and shift key, both the keys, hold and rightward arrow. See, the entire row has been selected. Now use the downward arrow, we are easily select all the complete data set. In case if you are using a very big data sheets, by that time it will be very helpful. Okay, as I told you, n number of Excel shortcut keys are there. You just go to that browse bar, you can search. See, I have given just Excel shortcut keys, some thing coming onto my screen. I randomly am clicking this, the Excel sheet form here, isn't it? See, this is the way we can get. Just to go to the particular site, you can see, and you can make use of this. Okay, right. Now, for example, this is the data. This complete entire column I want to hide. So how to hide? You just click on the column title there. The complete entire column will be selected. Now place mouse pointer anywhere in that selected area, right click. See, in that pop-up menu, we can see last but one to one, the hide. You just click that hide. See, ST, the T column has been hidden, isn't it? So how to get it back? You select S and U. Again, right click the mouse pointer. Now unhide is there. Just click the unhide, you'll be getting the unhide. So you can hide just to select the column. Unhide in the sense, the front and back, both the cells, both the column supposed to be selected. You see, hide, yes, and U, both the columns should be selected, otherwise you won't get that hidden column open. Okay, so alt key. See here, alt key also one of the shortcut keys you can make use. Just you click the alt key on keyboard, so all the menus highlighted with a character. So that character is nothing but the shortcut key to activate that particular menu. For example, you see this F key, the F key is associated with a file. If you want to invoke the file, now you can directly press the F key. Now see, the file menu, the file options has been selected. Now still the keys are there. This N is for new, O is for open, S is for save or save as. If you want to save as this file, you want to save another name, or if you want to save this, just click yes. So how we are getting this? Simply Alt FS, that's it. Alt FA, save us. So Alt FA is for save us. If you are coming to formulas, the formulas also so many options are there. Now I click the Alt key, we are able to see this shortcut keys. So over the period of time, if you are using these shortcut keys, now you can memorize those keys, right? You need not memorize all the keys, all the shortcut keys, but what are the keys you are frequently used in your scenario, work scenario, that will become the familiar with you, right? Now we are moving to the next one, that is the freeze pans. Now I have some the data set. So what are the data set length? You just click this title, column title. In the bottom we can see 892. This is the Titanic the database generally will be using for the data manipulations, R or Python. And so for example, I'm showing this. If you want to browse down, we are moving down, or we have to hold the browse bar, we have to come down. So we can see the last record just by coming to this place. 891 records are there, and I am pressing Control and Home. I am coming at top. Okay, now I want to, if I am coming down, what is this zero represents? What is this two represents? I don't know, because there is no title. So how to freeze this title so that easily I can understand if I am going down to the last record? So for that purpose, we can keep the mouse pointer here, the next row, so that the top the row will be freezed. So how to freeze? Go to the view, and here we can see the freeze bands. You just click this, the bottom small triangle. Now the three options, one is for the freeze pans left side as well as top side, both the sides will be freezed. That this one is for only title, row only will be getting freezed. This one is left side. Okay, now I want to freeze this one. Select the freeze top row. Now you just browse down, you see titles are simply standstill, isn't it? Simply remain. Even if you are going to the last record also, you can see this number belongs to survived. This number is for the people class. This one is a name, like that we can get the title. So this is how we can freeze the pan. Okay, in case the serial number also, in case if you are moving this side, see what is the serial number of this one? No idea. So how to freeze this serial number? That also can be done. You select these and go to this freeze pan. See, you select this. Now if you are moving this, that particular column, the particular column is has been freezed, so that easily we can understand this record is 15th one, this record is 21st or 20th, right? Okay, now in some scenario I want to freeze titles as well as this one column. So how to do that? You keep the mouse pointer at that point, intersection point. Okay, now go to freeze pans, you select the first one. Now even if you are going down, okay, that's already freezed. No, if you are selecting that, unfreezed, it becomes unfreezed. So now you keep the mouse pointer there, select the first one. Now see, the titles have been freezed. Now go to the right side, this one. So column as well as row titles are freezed. Now easily we can understand the title as well as the number of, okay, serial number. So this is the way we can freeze it. We can freeze a number of columns or a number of rows. For example, I want to hold up to this point all the rows and up to this column. Now keep the mouse pointer here, okay, so that the top side, these much rows, I see for identification and giving some color to this. This is a column from this column. So these rows should be freezed. At the same time, these columns also should be freezed. So I'm keeping the mouse pointer here and go to the view and see, this is unfreeze because already something in freeze mode. So I'm unfreezing best. Now it is freezes. Okay. Now, so keep the cursor point and go to this place and select the freeze pans. Now see, we are able to see a hairline, the horizontal line. Vertical, right? So if you are moving this side, we can see these many columns. Even if you are going down the top side, so this is the way we can do the freezing. This is all about the freezing. Now we are moving to the flash fill. In this flash fill, we have some records. This is in some situations we are entering the titles or names. You see, this is the first name, and Brown, Mr. Owen, Harris. These are four parts are there. If you are coming to the next one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, more than 5. Okay, here you see 1, 2, 3. We want to extract. We can use Control E as a shortcut key to extract it. See, I am typing Barack and enter. Now we can use Control and E. We are getting George. We are not getting next one, William, right? So the system requests some more practice. So the second also I am giving and click enter. Control E, we are getting this much, right? What is the meaning of this? Some record already existed as subparts, 1, 2, first name, middle name, last name, like that. I want to extract only first name here. Manually we cannot do that, but Excel giving us one short form shortcut key, so that with the help of the Control E we can get the first name. So before this, what pattern should be extracted? That pattern we are typing here. See, I am typing Barack. From this data I am selecting this one. Okay, the next I can try Control E. It is not giving any data, right? After typing the Barack, I am clicking enter. One more time I am giving practice to Excel. George. Now I am clicking. Now I am holding the Control key and E. I am not able to get. Once again, William, and click enter. Now I am typing Control E. See, first time it is not able to understand what the pattern I am typing. Next time George, from the second record also I have extracted, given to the Excel system saying that I need the first name to be extracted. Then also it is not able to get. The next one I tried a third time, the William. After giving the third name, I tried with Control G. It extracted the George, Ronald, James, Gerald, isn't it? So this is the way we can get it. So what pattern you are giving to the Excel system, it understands and it helps us to get such a same pattern from the given data. So this is how the flash fill will be working. Now I am going to extract the middle name. So middle name, what is the middle name of the first record? This one, the Hussain. I am typing here HU. Yes, you should give the correct spelling. Okay, Hussain. Now I try Control E. I am getting only one. No, I need more, right? So here I am typing manually Walker. Okay, now enter. Now try Control E. It is not giving. One more you can try. What is the next record? Next one is Jefferson. Okay, Jefferson, and click enter. Now try Control E. Now we are getting here and there. It is not properly giving more things. Control Z. Once again I'm going to try Herbert. B-E-R-T, right? Herbert. And now Control E. Now I am getting, isn't it? So the first try it is not able to give us. The second try also failure. The third, after giving the third record, failure. Fourth record we are getting, right? So we have to give some practice to the Excel system so that it will be trained by giving the first data, first or one or two data, after that will be able to get. So how many records are here? You see here 44 records are there, isn't it? 44 records are there. Even hundreds records, even you have hundreds of records, with the help of, by giving one or two practice, we can extract the first name or middle name or last name. So it is a amazing thing we can do with the help of the flash fill. I am going to try the last name. The first one is Obama, the next one is Bush, next one is Clinton, Okay, three data given. Now try Control D. Still some gaps are there, right? Why? Because this one is a four name, this one is only three name, this one is three name, this one is three name. So in case if you are getting these kind of data, we are not able to get, by the time you can give one more data one more time. So here instead of Bush we can give Walker, isn't it? So that is the third name. Now what is this? Here I will try. See, now we are able to get, because this one is only three parts in that name. Here it is four names. We tried here Clinton, but we tried here Bush. The Clinton is the third one, Bush is the fourth one. That is why the system getting confused. Okay, so this is the way we can make use of the flash fill, right? The flash fill is available here also. We can go to here the fill, here you can find the flash fill, right? Next exercise, flash fill is over. No, now we are going to flash fill 2. Here we can see these are some product code given. In this product code we are going to extract only 1000. See, 1000 is here. I am deleting and typing here 1000. Okay, the same way 1001 should be extracted like that. See, automatically from the first leftmost the code has been extracted. You come down here, it's a 101 10 100 101. That is, we are extracting right side three characters. See, the 100 is given and you just give Control E, it will be selecting 100. It is getting confused. So once again you give one more data, 100 already given, I am giving 101. Now you try Control E, now it is getting, isn't it? So whenever you are getting the wrong information by giving insufficient training to the Excel system, you give one more time as a training so that we can get it. Here 165, it is going to extract in the middle one, right? 165 is there. For safe side, I am giving 540, one more training to the system. Now I am trying with Control E, I am getting that. So this is the way we can extract. Okay, so this is a Monday. I am typing only M, first character. I will try this. If it is okay, yes, it is getting. So like that, Monday, two characters only. Control E, we are getting only two characters. And deleting this, already done. Examples here I am selecting Bangalore, and you see Control E, I am able to extract the first name. Like that, here also we can extract, and this one also we can do only the first one. So how we can do that? I am giving only two, and Control E, I am able to extract the first one. The same way 12 is given, that's a month. Control E, we are getting. And Control plus E, we are able to extract the last characters, isn't it? So organization. So this is one interesting one. See here, United States of America has given. I am saying each and every word, the first leftmost character as the acronym, the short name, right? USA. Like that, what is the second one? UK. So it's supposed to be come. You Control and E, see, only first word, second word, first characters. WHO. Like that, even you can give anything, anything. You see, I am giving Kalyan Kumar. Right here also, you see, I am extracting and deleting all these things. Okay, so clear. All contents, the USA is there. From here, Control E. See, my name also extracted here as KK. So this is the way we can generate the short keys of our names, abbreviations, short keys. In case if new employee is admitted in our organization, if you want to create some pass keywords, by the time we can make use of this kind of the thing, we can immediately give the shortcut keys. Okay, I will show that. Deepika, Control G, we are getting. The last name is, and enter Control E, we are able to get it. So this is the way we can use this flash fill as one of the useful tools. I hope this video is very helpful for you. Thank you for watching.